I'm saying, you put together a set of rules, and the people are going to look at these rules and say, okay, that's what I have to work with. If I want to run this series, I'm going to make my car in those rules. Okay, you can't say, well, you've got a Ford, this is your rules package. You've got a Chevy, you've got a Toyota, you've got a Dodge, you've got a Neon. What? You can't do that. You've got to make it fairly uniform as much as you can, top to bottom. Okay, now, if you're going to which, do you see what I'm saying?
I completely get what you're saying, but
I understand where you're coming from, but if you set this box up, and these are your rules in that box, and your car doesn't meet that,
I agree with you.
But that's what rules are for.
Exactly. But at the same time, if you put in there saying OEM suspension pickup points, okay, no changing your pickup points,
okay,
where bolt-ons go onto the frame.
Okay.
Okay. You now have to have tech guys that know where the pickup points are on a Camaro, on a Monte Carlo, on Ford products, on Dodge products.
Novas.
I mean, how many different Chevys are there that fall into this? And then you got to find.
But look at the guys that are on that street stock series. The guys doing the tech, I'll tell you right now, those guys know that.
I hope they do.
They do.
Because I'll tell you right now, there's going to. I with this much money on the line, people are going to push the envelope.
People are going to build cars to fit those rules to race that series, is what they're going to do. Because if your car doesn't meet. You're going to have the guys that push the limits. Every class has it everywhere. That's fine. But if it meets that rules that you've put together, great. Now, if a guy's got a car that's not working very good, and he knows that, and he sees this rules package, what's he gonna do?
Find every gray area possible,
or buy a car and build a car that fits that rules package,
or just go out and buy one.
See, I'm against that. Everybody knows my feelings on that.
I know. But when you start talking, this much money on the line, what do you do?
I understand where you're coming from. I just think that it needs to be. My whole point in that rant was, I think that you need to be more. Don't let this guy run the series for your money. When he doesn't run the series, he's only there for one race. You're going to his home track, and his car's not legal for your series. So if your car's not legal for the series, I'm sorry. Looks like you're running with your class and you're not taking our money tonight.
Maybe the answer to that and the solution to that is they run it like they did this year, but the track pays out the track purse. And then if you're running the series pays out the series pays out the series purse to the series drivers.
But you're not looking at the big picture. You're looking at money for one race. I'm talking championship, okay? That's going to affect drivers and championship points.
I watched it happen this year in a Hornet race.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Never seen it again. Car was there for one race.
And it was a car that clearly didn't meet any rules packages anywhere.
He claimed it was bone stock.
Uh-huh, right. If that car was bone stock, I'm Michael Jordan.
Yeah, exactly. As we all looked and rolled our eyes. But, and he came for one race, cleaned up, took the big money, and left.
That's exactly why you don't.
It's all, yeah. These
you
are,
understand what
yeah,
I'm saying.
Clearly.
I understand what both of you guys are saying. I think we're saying it all like three different ways.
I just, and Chris will figure it out.
Oh, absolutely.
And I think
Chris
here's the thing. Chris isn't dumb. Chris, I'll tell you, this was a learning year for Chris. He did a fantastic job. That series, I'm saying it, that series is going to be bigger next year.
I agree.
You're going to see more cars. You're going to see more sponsorship. And I won't doubt if you see more money.
And he learned a lot from these past two. He's going to just do nothing but just enhance it.
Right.
It's going to be right on the money.
Right. And I think that that's exactly what's going to happen. I like the series. I like the idea because the series goes to so many different types of racetracks.
Oh, yeah.
Be it the big track at Willamette, the asphalt track at Roseburg, the bull ring at Banks, Madras.
The tire-eating machine at Coos Bay.
Southern Oregon Speedway. I mean, you've got all these racetracks are different from each other. And when you've got these guys following that series, I think it's a great test for driver ability. It'll test your skill.
Mm-hmm.
It'll test not just the talent in the seat, but what's in your head. Changing that car, it's a lot like going from, say, the NASCAR series when they go from, say, Pocono to Martinsville.
Mm-hmm. Oh, geez, that is a joke.
You see what I'm saying? That's kind of what you have on this series when you go from somewhere like, I don't know, Sunset to Willamette.
And then an asphalt track.
And then down to an asphalt track.
It's a lot like the Wild West Modified Speed Week.
Yep. Right.
You're going to so many different tracks.
Talk about a great series.
I mean.
Yeah. Unbelievable.
The talent that comes out. It's going to be fun next year. I'm really excited to see what's going to happen with this Road to the Iron Giant series.
And talking about next year, listen to this comment. We need to be hard on tech every week and enforce the rules. If not, you're going to lose racers, the costs go up, and the tracks get bad-mouthed.
Mm-hmm. I like that comment.
That is the most accurate statement we have seen in the Swear Trucking chat line all night.
That's a very intelligent statement.
That is 100% solid gold truth right there.
Whoever said it, thank you.
Let me read that again. We need to be hard on tech every week and enforce the rules. If not, you're going to lose racers, the costs go up, and the tracks get bad-mouthed. Mm-hmm. Who's bad-mouthing the track in that situation? Where does that start? With the racers, exactly.
Yep. And it holds when you get caught, and we've said it before, when you get caught, when a big series comes to town, like the Road to the Iron Giant, the Wild West Modified Speed Week, mm-hmm. when you have outside tech officials who are good at what they do, and that's all they do, come to your track and sit and pop one of your local racers you've been letting get by for something.
That might not be intentional cheating.
Exactly. It's not intentional cheating, but at the same time, it holds your track in bad light with the sanctioning body.
Exactly. And I know exactly what you're talking about when you say that. When you talk about Curtis Towns and that whole situation at Cottage Grove. Find one person in that modified rank in the sports that will say Curtis is a cheater.
You ain't going to do it.
You're not going to. That's not how Curtis Towns races. He's not that guy.
You're not going to find a more stand-up guy and more stand-up competitor that's going to be by the book.
Right.
He got caught.
Because of an interpretation that he read in the rule book that he...
And I will not deny it. I had the same interpretation.
And I see how that interpretation... After we had that discussion early in the season, I can see how that can be interpreted the way it was.
And, well, you remember...
Yes, I
do. How hot I was over that. Yeah. I was...
That was a major discussion on the show for not just 1 week, but a couple. But what did that do? That said, the track favors him. They're letting him get away with that. No, that's not the case.
No.
That's not the case. Oh, the track doesn't have tech. They're not teching anybody. Maybe. I don't know. I'm not at that track. But.
Is it raining back there?
If you have that weekly tech that this racer is talking about and they're doing their job, that driver wouldn't have had that happen at an IMCA sanctioned series event. I mean, that was a big deal.
Well, and here you look, go back east. Look at some of the tech that they deal with back east. Because, I mean, perfect example. Kyle Strickler went back, won that 50,000 to win race. You know what they did to the top five? They took their tires.
Right.
They took Kyle's engine, even though it was an IMCA sealed 604 with GM bolts intact and IMCA sails intact. They seized his motor. They seized the tires of the top five. They seized other components off the top five cars. And they sent the tires to a lab. They took Kyle's motor, even though it was still sealed, tore it all the way down,
mm-hmm.
even though it was still GM sealed, to check.
I will tell you, you are going to see this at Bakersfield. You are going to see pre-tech. I'm not kidding you guys. You're going to see pre-tech like you haven't seen before. Now, we saw this when Moxie was down at the Duel in the Desert last year. We stood there and watched them tech these cars, and I'm talking a 16th of an inch. They're saying, nope, ask Tony Breakall. Nope, that fin is a 16th of an inch. Take it back and trim it. And he had to be approved to race.
I agree.
A 16th of an inch, and these guys are saying, sorry, this is what the rule says.
Exactly, and we all know racers. They're going to find the gray area, but Corey, how much time we got left on the ticker there, buddy?
Well, we got 5 minutes left. We're running out of time. I want to close things up here on Northwest Dirt News. But great discussion tonight, you guys. I want to say, everybody, thanks for listening. good show. A lot of activity on the Sweer Trucking chat line.
And don't be afraid to call in next week.
Yeah, I mean,
we'll
you
be
know
here.
The number.
Maybe
503.
We should start calling people.
862-3478.
Dirt. Real quick, before we get out of here, I have to do this because these guys mean so much to our show, to us. We've developed friendships and relationships with these guys. Without our sponsors on this show, it makes it so hard to do. You know, these guys are helping us, and we'll do everything we can to promote them. Again, we want to say thanks to Archer Floor Coverings, Northwest Trucking Academy, Amco Transmissions, Total Car Care Center here in Corvallis, Stoneman J Livestock, Sweer Trucking, James Gang Pizza, Jetstream Aqua Massage, and the parent company, Moxie Meeting Promotions. We've got an awesome package with us, you know, these guys helping us out. We've got some more sponsors coming on board. Again, deals aren't finalized yet, and that'll be happening pretty soon. But, you know, you guys, hey, you want to advertise on the number one dirt track show in the Northwest? You know where we're at. You know our number. You know how to get a hold of us. It's that easy. We can help.
503-862-3478.
It's not as expensive as you might think.
That's the thing right there. Yeah. Everybody thinks it's so expensive. Really not. You're talking radio.
We've got packages starting at what? $75 going up to as much as you want to do.
Right.
We have every package to meet every business's needs.
The best thing about advertising on Northwest Dirt News, we're marketing to a captive audience that is interested in what you're doing.
Exactly.
We're all racers. We've got 20,000-plus listeners around the country. We can help you. If you're interested, give us a call. And again, all of our sponsors, everybody helping us out, we appreciate you. We love you. It's been a great racing season. We're heading down to the Budweiser Nationals. We're going to talk about that. And, yes, we are going to broadcast that live on Spreaker Radio, just like you're listening to Northwest Dirt News. We can get you on the air, part of that program there, and it's going to be a good deal. Tune in and listen to us. We'll be back next Wednesday night from the Amco Transmissions Total Car Care Studio. For Northwest Dirt News, I'm Corey Penfold.
I'm Joel Momora.
And I'm Handsome Dom.
And we'll see you
at the races.
She's a good girl, loves her mama, loves Jesus in America too. She's a good girl, is crazy about Elvis, loves horses and her boyfriend too. And it's a long living in Reseda, there's a freeway running through the yard. And I'm a bad boy, 'cause I don't even miss her. I'm a bad boy for breaking her heart. Ventura Boulevard, and all the bad boys are standing in the shadows, and the good girls are home with broken hearts.